La transition vers l'économie circulaire.
Transition towards circular economy, which is anticipated in the law published in 2015, is based on a hierarchy of resources. So let's talk about this hierarchy. First, we want to prevent, we need to prevent the use of resources because we will have to use less resources per inhabitant to be able and share with the 8 billion people present on this planet at the end of this century. We also want to promote a lean and responsible consumption of resources to limit extraction. It's also about using resources from recycling, not to dig into new resources. And it's about using renewable resources, which need to comply with the renewal cycle of these resources, and we need to use these resources in the right way. Then we also need to use recyclable resources if we don't want to use resources from recycling. And we also need to use other resources which are neither recyclable nor reusable. In order to implement circular economy, a certain number of actions are possible, and they're organized according to three areas and seven pillars. So what are the three areas? We need to work on the offering from economic players, then we need to act on consumers' behaviors and demand, and then we need to act on managing waste. So what are these seven pillars? For the offering from economic players, we need to secure sustainable supply and extract resources taking into account the hierarchy of these resources. And then we also need, for buyers, they need to have genuine policies for sustainable procurement, and that's the case for local authorities and should be the case for companies, and these local authorities need to set the example in terms of sustainable procurement. Second pillar is eco-design. That's about products and processes. We need a design by taking into account all environmental impacts and more specifically the use of resources and raw materials, but also taking into account all environmental impacts, not to transfer some of the impacts to other parts of the environment. Another pillar is about developing territorial economy, so the ability of players to work together and make sure that the waste produced by some become resources for others. That's a policy which is carried out over a limited territory, but leading to industrial symbiosis when a certain number of synergies are identified between the various players. Fourth pillar is about the economy of functionality. What is it about? Well, it's shifting from selling a product to selling the use of a product. The company keeps ownership of the products and sells the use of this product through units. We've seen that with Michelin. They've changed their economic model for large transportation fleets, and they no longer sell the tires, but they sell kilometers. We also have tests of new economic models in the field of light with the arrival of LEDs, which and players no longer sell the equipment, but they sell luxes of light used by users. Then, if we look at demand and behavior of consumers, there is this sustainable consumption that needs to be developed with citizens. We need to procure in a responsible fashion. We don't have to change our equipment because there is a new color available on the market, because technologies have made progress. We can see that with smartphones, which have a use time which is much less than the technical life cycle of this equipment. We also need to develop on collaborative consumption. Collaborative consumption means sharing products with others. Instead of buying a drilling machine that you will just use for 15 minutes, you can share with your neighbors. This is also about car sharing. to limit the number of cars out there. And it's all in terms of responsible consumption. It's using the equipment in the right way to make them last as long as possible. Another aspect is to increase the use time of products, and that goes through re-employing products. Re-employing, when you have a piece of equipment that you no longer use, you can give it, you can sell it. But when you need a piece of equipment, you can buy it second-hand or source it with your family or your neighbours who would be in a position to provide you with such a piece of equipment. It's all about repairing equipment. Equipment can break down, and instead of buying a new piece of equipment because you're attracted by technology or by the new model, maybe it's more relevant to repair this piece of equipment with a professional person or talking to people who can give you advice and help you repair the piece of equipment. And when you no longer need a piece of equipment, you can send it to the recycling agencies for it to be recycled, repaired, and reused. Another pillar is waste management, with the development of recycling, reuse, whether we're talking about recycling materials or recycling organic waste that you have in your environment. This recycling is something that has developed over a long period of time, but it's not the only answer to circular economy. When talking about circular economy, we might just link this type of economy to recycling, but the capacities of recycling are limited with regards to products which are still being used, and the efficacy of recycling is also limited. So circular economy is based on each and every of these seven pillars, and it's the development of these seven pillars that will lead us to circular economy.